French and U.S. lawmakers visiting Taiwan this week. The five-member delegation from France has arrived in Taipei and is set to stay in the island until Monday. They are scheduled to meet with high-ranking officials to discuss a range of issues, including regional security. This is the first Taiwan trip by a high-level European delegation since a string of visits by U.S. officials began last month. On Wednesday, another U.S. delegation is expected to touch down in Taiwan. The lawmakers, led by Florida Representative Stephanie Murphy, will stay there until Friday. The visits come as Taiwan's military holds 2 days of live-fire drills. China last month held its largest military drills around Taiwan after U.S. House Speaker Nancy Pelosi visited the island, which Beijing claims as its own. Britain's newly installed Prime Minister Liz Truss making history with her cabinet roster. For the first time, people of color dominate the country's most important ministerial positions. James Cleverly will be the first foreign secretary with African roots. Suella Braverman was named Home Secretary, succeeding a fellow colleague of Indian origin. Kwasi Kwarteng, who also traces his roots to Africa, is the new finance minister. With her cabinet in place, Truss is confident she can ride out the economic storm hounding the UK.
Our people have shown grit, courage and determination time and time again. We now face severe global headwinds caused by Russia's appalling war in Ukraine and the aftermath of COVID. Now is the time to tackle the issues that are holding Britain back. I know that we have what it takes to tackle those challenges. Of course, it won't be easy, but we can do it. We will transform Britain into an aspiration nation with high-paying jobs, safe streets, and where everyone everywhere has the opportunities they deserve.
The UN nuclear watchdog calls for the creation of a safety and security zone around Ukraine's embattled Zaporizhzhia nuclear power plant. The International Atomic Energy Agency issued that call in a report following a visit to the plant last week. The watchdog underscored the need for interim measures to prevent a nuclear accident as shelling continues to hit the site. But the agency was careful not to apportion blame to either Ukraine or Russia, which has been occupying the plant. Ukrainian President Volodymyr Zelensky says he would support the proposed security zone if it aims to demilitarize the vicinity of the plant. We begin in South Korea, where the death toll from Typhoon Hinnamnor's wrath climbs to 10. Officials say 7 of the fatalities drowned after they were trapped in an underground car park in the southeastern city of Pohang. Rescuers managed to pull out 2 survivors from the scene, who are now in stable condition. South Korean President Yoon Suk-yeol says Pohang suffered the worst damage across the country. Damage to buildings and roads were also reported in the cities of Busan and Ulsan. Thousands were also displaced. Hinnamnor is the strongest typhoon to hit South Korea in years. The Philippines seeks to step up its fight against climate change. The budget department is asking Congress for some 450 billion pesos next year to help fund climate-related initiatives. That's higher than this year's budget of 289 billion pesos. The government aims to combat deforestation as well as conserve and protect watersheds. President Marcos earlier vowed to increase funds for climate change programs by an average of 15% annually. A storm is expected to enter the Philippines tonight. The tropical storm was last spotted 1,445 kilometers east of northern Luzon, with maximum winds of 65 kilometers per hour and gusts of up to 80 kilometers per hour. It will be assigned the local name Inday. The storm is forecast to develop into a severe tropical storm in the next 24 hours, but it is unlikely to bring heavy rainfall and severe winds.